Back when I was a kid, Heritage Round in the AFL used to be one of my favourite rounds for the season. Seeing all those old Guernseys used to really bring out some nostalgic feelings amongst a lot of the AFL community, and I think it's a shame that Heritage Round was ultimately canned. So what happened to Heritage Round? The idea of a Heritage Round first came up as early as 1996, when on round 7 of that year, the original 8 teams all played against one another in the exact identical fixture of round 1, 1897, as part of celebrating the AFL's 100th season. For example, Essendon played Geelong on Saturday, 8th of May, 1897 for the very first time, and would play on the exact same date in 1996 to represent the occasion of reaching 100 seasons. All 8 teams additionally played in their original jumpers as well, which was a very popular move with the fans. Fast forward 7 years later and Heritage Round was born. On round 19, 2003, 14 of the 16 teams properly donned Heritage kits, with a lot of these kits even dating back as far as the late 1800s, like Fremantle's original kit as a state team from 1896 to 1899, Geelong's original hoops Guernsey from 1897 to 1907, as well as Essendon's smaller red sash dating all the way back to 1897 as well. Adelaide and West Coast, who happened to be playing each other, were not participating in wearing Heritage jerseys, given the relatively recent histories of the clubs then. Heritage Round would be even bigger in 2004, where round 18 would see all 16 teams take part in the theme of wearing retro Guernseys. While some of the teams wore the same Guernsey they wore the previous year, other teams did decide to change it up a bit, like Brisbane Lions wearing the old Brisbane Bears singlet, Richmond donning their kit from all the way back to the VFA days, and North Melbourne would follow suit too by acknowledging their past roots in the VFA. Even the umpires joined in for 2004, where they wore traditional white along with those long coats. 2005's Heritage Round would be even more towards the back end of the season, now in round 20. This would be the first year where people would start to question the concept of Heritage Round, especially when you have teams like Essendon who haven't really changed the look of their Guernsey during their existence in the VFL/AFL, wearing the same red sash, unless you go back to the VFA days where their first ever recorded jumper was navy blue well back in the 1870s. Sydney and Fremantle would also wear the same shirts as they did in the two previous Heritage Rounds. In saying this, teams did wear some rather cool retro kits. For example, Hawthorn's kit from the early 1900s, which looks like something the Bulldogs would have worn instead, as well as St Kilda's Great War era Guernsey, which looked like the German flag, and they did have to change this during the time as well due to anti-German sentiment. 2006 would signal the first year where Heritage Round would actually introduce a particular theme which clubs had to follow. The theme for round 16 was the electrifying 80s, and every team barring Port Adelaide would take part in wearing a kit from the 80s. Essendon and Richmond would both go further and wear shorts of the same colour as their respected sashes. The only team that wore a Guernsey from a different era was Fremantle, who wore that same kit predominantly from the 1890s. I guess Sydney also wore the exact same kit as they have for all the previous Heritage Rounds, but at least they did technically wear this kit for quite a bit of the 80s. 2007 saw interest in Heritage Round dwindle slightly as Collingwood and St Kilda both elected not to wear Heritage kits. The theme this year was based around the 70s. The biggest talking point about this year's Heritage Round was definitely Port Adelaide being given permission to wear their Prison Bars shirt against the Western Bulldogs. Port had intended to wear the Prison Bars Guernsey the previous year, but this was banned after strong protests from Collingwood and especially from Eddie McGuire. Heritage Round would mostly be idle in 2008 with the exception of one match in round 19 where Geelong played Melbourne, with both teams wearing their kits from the 1890s to the early 20th century. 2008 was to be the final round of Heritage Round, as it was not to come back in 2009, and to this present day, it still has not returned. So why did Heritage Round get scrapped? Well, there hasn't really been an official reason. There is big speculation, however, that the feud over Port Adelaide's Prison Bars shirt between the Power and Collingwood may have been the tipping point for Heritage Round's existence. As mentioned, Port Adelaide were banned from wearing this Guernsey in 2006, as Collingwood wanted to be recognised as the only team associated with the black and white colours, or the black and white shirt rather. This ban, as I mentioned previously, was overturned in 2007, but on the condition they could never wear it against the Magpies. This feud between the two clubs even continues to this day. Less likely reasons have also been touted, like the new expansion sites of Gold Coast Suns and GWS coming into the competition, and being new clubs, they'd obviously not have old kits as of yet. And even reasons like low heritage kit sales and falling interest over time are a possibility why it was ultimately given the axe. So in my opinion, would I bring it back? Well, I do think that teams genuinely don't do enough in terms of wearing the odd heritage Guernsey, but in saying this, some teams are worse offenders than others when it comes to this. Ideally, I would love to see it come back, and in the social media age that we are living in, I think it would actually be more successful today than what it was back then. However, it doesn't necessarily have to come back. Teams can decide to wear a retro kit without the need for a round dedicated to it, and this could happen in the form of having an old heritage kit for some teams as a clash kit. But of course, depending on the colour pattern schemes of clubs, it would be more feasible for some clubs than others. So let me know in the comments section if you would love to see Heritage Round make a comeback. Subscribe to the channel and like the video if you enjoyed it.